Number one, Planned Parenthood is opening one of the largest abortion clinics in the country, 15 miles from the Missouri border in Illinois. Planned Parenthood officials said the 18,000 square foot clinic in Fairview Heights will provide abortion care as well as family planning. It is set to open later this month.
Number two, Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders was hospitalized in Las Vegas after experiencing chest discomfort at an event there. Doctors inserted two stents in the blocked artery of the 78-year-old. The Democratic presidential candidate, who advocates major health care reform, tweeted, "I'm fortunate to have good health care and great doctors and nurses helping me to recover."
Number three, a Dallas jury sentenced Amber Geiger to 10 years in prison. The former police officer was convicted of murdering her unarmed neighbor in his own apartment. Geiger testified she had entered Botham Jean's apartment by mistake, thinking it was her own. After the sentencing, the victim's younger brother embraced Geiger.
And number four, happening today, the man who resigned as U.S. Special Envoy to Ukraine last Friday is expected to appear for a closed-door deposition with three House committees this morning. Kurt Volker was named as one of the Americans who talked to Rudy Giuliani about his meetings with Ukrainian officials in the whistleblower complaint. That's at the center of a House impeachment inquiry.
Number five, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention will update the numbers of vaping-related deaths and illnesses nationwide later today. Just yesterday, Alabama announced its first death from a vaping-associated illness. That brings the total number of deaths nationwide to at least 18. The CDC last reported 805 vaping-related lung injuries.
And number six, and new this morning, a huge settlement to resolve claims stemming from the October 2017 Las Vegas massacre is expected to be announced today. That's according to people briefed on the plans. In May, MGM Resorts says it could pay as much as $800 million in liabilities tied to the mass shooting where 58 people were killed and more than 800 were injured.
And number seven, we do have a flood warning out for many areas of the tri-states due to the rain we had over the weekend and some heavy rain just in the last 12 hours. We'll talk about the big cool down that's expected to kind of stick around here in the tri-states.